Creating a grainy gradient background can add depth and texture to your designs. This effect can make your design stand out and gives them a unique look. And it is quite easy to do. So that is why I want to show you a step-by-step tutorial on creating a grainy gradient background using Photoshop in just a few simple steps. To start, open a new file and select a Canva size. For this video, I recommend choosing 4000 by 3000 pixels, 300 dpi and RGB color mode. In the next step, you should unlock the background layer and then double-click on it to open the layer style window. Within the window, locate the gradient overlay option. Here, you need to set the style to angle and then adjust the angle degree to your desired value. Personally, I prefer using 90 degree angle. Now it is time to choose your gradient colors. Here you can use any preset gradients or create your custom one. However, I highly recommend using at least 3 colors that work together to make the gradient background more vibrant and colorful. Once satisfied with your gradient, click OK. And now it's time to right-click on the layer and choose Rasterize Layer Style. To make the background truly gradient, you need to go into Filter and then find a blur and select the Gaussian blur. This action will open a new window in which you can adjust the radius. The goal is to achieve a natural-looking gradient with smooth transition between colors, avoiding district lines. I prefer using values that exceed 500 in order to achieve a smooth gradient without visible lines between the colors. And now, to get the noisy effect in your gradient background, you need to go again to the filter and then find the noise section and select the Add Noise option. In the new window, you should adjust the amount of noise you desire. For a smooth yet noisy gradient, select the uniform distribution and choose a value between 5 and 30. While this is a matter of preference, for this tutorial, I will set the value at 70%. And there you have it, a grainy gradient background that you can use in various designs. This effect is versatile and can be tailored to fit different color schemes and design needs. Just play with it, add different colors that are matching more your future designs. So, I hope this tutorial was helpful, and if you have any questions, use the comment section and I will try to reply.